next flower in this release is the pom-pom dahlia. It's, we're going to have a kitty cat here in a second. It's been described as a lollipop on a stick because these smaller round flowers, which are smaller than the ball dahlias, they actually grow almost 3 feet high. But before we get started on the dahlias, I wanted to show you the parasol, just a quick little trick that I've done with it. So I've cut one out of double-sided cardstock, but I've actually backed it with extra paper just so it'll be a little firmer. And then I've cut two handles to it, and I'm just going to glue them together. This gives a little bit of dimension to them. You know, you can see the difference a little bit. It raises it up. I'll put these two together. The other thing I do is make what I call a bridge. So it's nothing more than this piece is 3.5 inches by 1 inch. And I score it at 1/2 inch, 1.5, 2, and 2.5. Because what you're going to create is this little box. So you just glue those together, and we can put some glue here. I actually lay that down and set it over top there, but you can, and then slide it into place. So you've got this little 1/2 inch bridge, and if I hide it under, and I'm going to do it with the side down, if I hide it under my umbrella or parasol, then when I want to do my handle, I'll glue that on. And what that does is gives me some space underneath. So let's glue the parasol in place. I've got a card here. I'm going to move some things back so you can see. Move some of these over. I've got a kitty on the side here, so he's taking up part of my space here. So let's glue this down. So I'm first going to glue that little bridge or stepping. And I've kind of eyeballed this, so I want it right in here. And then I can go ahead and put some glue on this. Oops. And set my handle in place. Now, I do have, there's little embossed edges that show you to fold back so you can add the glue onto that. You'll get the little score lines so you can bend back. It's a little more difficult when I did this with double paper, but still I could do it. And so I'm going to set it in place. And then because I have a magnetic board here, I'm going to use these weights to hold it down. If you don't have that, you might want to, you know, put something heavy on it or hold it for a second so it'll be in place. Now, normally I would push this over to the side here, but I've got a, I don't know if you can see, Harper's little paws are sticking out here. So let's see if I can get it just off camera here, but still in the. So here's the die. It has a large petal piece that has 6 petals. Cut it 3 times, and I've done that here. And then you've got a plate that has all the other pieces that you cut twice. So they're 4 sizes. And then we've got a middle petal that will roll up. There's also a set of leaves here that you can cut 2 to 3 times, whatever your preference of how many. And you can see I've already started rolling some of these up. Now the interesting thing of the pom-pom dahlia, it almost, they call it like quilling. You create these tubes. So let me color the large one here first. I'm going to do it in a pink. But, you know, be bold. There are lots of colors from white, yellow, purples, orange, reds, you know, and pinks, of course. And you can just have fun even doing very variegated ones. There's a pretty pink one with darker on the edges that you could create as well. Just let your imagination go, and you can look these up online and see all the different colors you can do them in. These, like I said, grow to almost 3 feet, 30 to 35 inches. So they're taller than their cousin, the ball dahlia, or the cactus dahlia that I've done before. So I'm going to turn these all over, right sides down, and spritz them with a little bit of water. And I'm going to hold it back here a little bit so it's just a light mist. You want to do that because it helps hold your petals together. So you're going to do this quilling effect. So what I do is I take, and if you're right-handed, if you're left-handed, you'll do it from the other side and push it. So since I've lost part of my thumb, that's kind of hard to do on this side. So I rely on my left hand. Then you're going to grab it. See, I'm not grabbing it in the middle, but I'm grabbing it towards the stem area there. And I'm going to roll that into, the other one's going to go on top. And I'm going to hold that and release it. And that's how you get your little tube or quilled look. For you beekeepers, it's also known as a honeycomb effect. So I'm just going to go around this one. Make sure, I want to make sure I really press that left side around the tube of the right side. That's perfect. That's what you would want to get. So if you hold it up to here so you can roll it in. And I'm going to go around all six petals. See, that one's kind of bent, so I'm going to just take that a little bit. You want to make sure you get it tight towards the center there, up in here. That's what holds that tube together. Okay. Now I'm going to do that to these next three sizes. So as you can see, I've rolled all the petals from the largest to the next three after that. The smaller one, it would be kind of hard to roll. So what you do is after you spritz it, and if it gets a little dry, just re-wet your board here and put a little bit of water on it. And then you take the switch to the smaller detailed tweezers, and I'm going to pinch tightly around them. I won't get quite the tube effect, but I do get them pinched together. Especially get some glue and stuff off my hands. See, I've got a green fingers from coloring leaves. And then this one is the rolled up one. So you want to get your molding mat out. You're going to put it face down on your molding mat and take your small ball stylus and just go and cup each one of those little rounded areas. And I'll show you what that looks like when it's rolled up. Let me grab my other tweezers here and my glue. All the way out to the end. Then when you roll it up, and I'm going with that little tail that I grabbed with my tweezer, and see how it rounds out. It has actually looks like a little bud. slide that off. Now we're ready to put it together. So what I have is, I call it my molding mat and my gluing mat. I keep one that, yeah, I glue on. I know we all do it, but I try to keep one kind of clean. So I'm going to cup this, move it over to that side. This is the larger petals. So I'm going to cup these three using my medium ball stylus. And then I'm going to glue. So I'm putting some glue on the end. And let me grab my tweezers here. Oops, sorry, Harper. And I'm going to offset it. Oh, he's going to help me. I know, you want to hold the tweezers too. Now I go around and make sure they're offset. You're going to hold my hand. And then this is the third one. So let me grab my glue stick here. And again, I'm making sure they're offset in between. And you can take your time to do this. And that's the first layer. So here's the next largest petal. I'm going to cup that one too using my ball stylus. Again, in between, kind of offsetting. But you see how spritzing it with a little bit of water does hold that shape of the honeycomb or tube, whatever you want to call it, in place. Here's the next size. Now I'm going to switch out and use my smallest ball stylus on these. Again, I'm going to get that in between. Okay, size number, well, it'd be number four. And I know it's going to look like it's going to get a little tight in the center, but you'll see. You really need this. Someone called it a lollipop on a stick because it really does, you know, it's really nice and full and round. And as you spread out the petals and get them in between everything, see how nice that's coming together. And then our last set of six petals here. And then what I do is just take that little bud area and you can dip it right in your glue pot and right in the center. See, it does all work out. And you've got a lovely pom-pom dahlia. For the leaves, I'm doing the YG 8.7 and YG 8.5 in Olo. If you have Copic, it would be YG 97 and YG 85. So I'm going to start with that darker green and come up from the stem area and then switch over to my little lighter green to give some highlights to the leaf. And then switch it over and just color the underside with that lighter 8.5. You'll need your molding mat, or your leaf mat, rather, and you're going to put on the leaf right side down. You're going to give it a stem. just dragging your leaf tool right down the center. And then I bend it in half, and I'm gonna do a blending of color here. So I'm using that lighter green in the Pan Pastel to go over it. And then I want it toned down a little bit, but I want some highlights. So I use the next shade down, which are all in my sets. Now these get veins going out to the side. Don't cross over your stem line. You want to keep it embossed. And then I can bring in my molding pad here. I'm going to pinch it with my tweezers at the stem end and grab my medium ball stylus and just kind of scrunch that end together. Stick around and we're going to put our project together. So my parasol is down. I'm going to move some of these away so you can see it better. And the reason why I lifted it up, now I've got room behind. And I've taken some, these are some lemongrass leaves that I had from the Victorian garden. They're nice and tall and pretty. And see, I can put it behind, and I can even put behind my holder there, my handle to my parasol. And put that one a little closer in. Make sure it stays within the card size. And then I have the acacia. Now, this one's the new one with this release. Great fillers. You can do, you know, as many as you like, but I'm gonna put some in here just to start filling out some foliage in the background. You know, when, even florists put together, you know, the, you have to have foliage. Again, I want to keep it within the boundaries of the card there. And having the two different colors of greenery makes it kind of nice too. I'm going to fold these in a little bit, pinch them up. Makes it a nice background. You know, you've got some color going on there, and slide that one right in there. I'm going to add that pom-pom. I can do it right on top because I've got my leaves behind there. I'll even put one all different colors to, but you don't, you know, this would be pretty with just, let me try to stick that one in there. And then just grab your leaves for your dahlias and tuck them under here. Looks like I gotta put a little there. Oops, wrong way. Goes this way. And I can even put one of the leaves coming back here so you get more little ones here. Like I said, you can cut as many as you like. I didn't cut as many with this project just because I had the foliage behind with the, put one here. And I've added, you know, one of the Better Press sentiments, feel better soon, because I thought this would be a lovely gift card for someone under the weather. You know, flu season's coming up again and everything. So let me just get a ladybug and we'll finish this up. So I've colored my ladybug with R1.5. I'm adding, just using a Uniball pen to add her spots and her little head. I know this eraser is pretty grungy. Here, we could turn it over on this side. It's just I've used it for so long making ladybugs. It's kind of, you know, just part of me here. So then I use my small ball stylus and I'm cupping her. So when I turn her over, you really have that illusion that she's dimensional here. Oops, she scoots around. Pretty soon the ladybugs are going to go into hibernation, at least here. I'll put her right on the front here. Always test out my glaze before I go to my project, just so in case it squirts out, I keep a little plastic tray next to me, a lid I save. So that's our project with the pom-pom dahlia. I hope you try this one. It's really quite the beauty and so interesting with these quilled petals. Mm-hmm.